If you watched the video on how to do an advanced search, we're going to pick up right where we left off with the search that we were doing for serial killer and brains. So we're just going to hit search and check out our results page. So we got almost 14,000 results, a decent number, certainly plenty to work with, and it's not unlikely, especially in ProQuest Central, to get 100,000 results, 200,000 results. Don't panic and think that that is way too many to deal with. First of all, in most databases, they're going to be, by default, sorting by relevance, which means that the best matches to the search you did should be coming up first. And of course, we can narrow some by publication date. If you get somewhere in the realm of 500,000 results, to me, that's a red flag. And you might want to think about adding another search term. You probably did a search that's too broad, so you need to narrow it down some. So in terms of publication date, of course, you want to make sure that you know your topic well enough to know how current your sources really need to be. A good general rule of thumb is at least in the past 5 years to be considered current. But of course, if there have been recent laws passed, recent technological breakthroughs related to your topic, then you may have to use much more current sources. So your options for narrowing by publication date, if you scroll down over on the left, ProQuest gives you the options of the last 12 months, last 5 years, last 10 years, or you can click custom date range, go in and type in a specific date range, either to maybe have a compromise date of 3 years or something like that, somewhere between 12 months and 5 years. Or if you want a very, very specific date range, let's say you're researching 9/11 and you want to find articles that were printed right after it happened, you could search 9/11/2001 to 9/14/2001 and narrow it down to that tight date range of just a few days. For the sake of argument, let's just do the last 5 years here. And that cut out quite a few of our results. If we narrow by a publication date and then decide, oh wait, that took out too many of my results, then you can always X out the filter that you used. And this is true of any other filters. So if we scroll down a little bit, you could also narrow by a specific type of source. We could click on magazines, it would get rid of everything else. So if we use any of these filters on the left, it will show you the filter you've used with an X. You can always exit out and go back to your original results. Now let's just say that we're happy with our publication date. And what you want to think of now is just looking over your results, probably skimming the first couple of pages. Just looking at the titles and a little bit of the description, seeing where your search terms are coming up, and see if it looks like you're seeing what you were looking for. Looks to me like some of the stuff at the top of our first page of results wasn't really related, but as we get a little further down here, we're definitely finding some things that are looking at the idea of the relationship between a serial killer's brain and some of his behavior. So if you feel like you are seeing a fair amount of sources that seem to be relevant to your search, then that's great news. Then we can just go ahead and start opening some of them up, looking them over, deciding which ones might be useful sources for you. If not, if you're not really seeing what you were looking for, then you have to ask yourself, well, why not? What is it that I'm seeing? Is it just kind of all over the place? And so maybe I need to add a search term, narrow it down some, focus it in more. Is it that you're seeing Nazis everywhere? Maybe you need to add the Boolean operator not and get rid of something. So let's say that now we're happy with our search results. And let's open up a random article here. And I just want to show you a few tools that you can use. The number one tool that's really going to be helpful to you in writing your paper in MLA style is the citation tool. Pretty much every database will have this. Click where it says cite here, I do have it set to default to MLA in the ProQuest databases. So you can just copy and paste this right into your Works Cited page. Now, I said just, but I don't really mean it. My disclaimer is always that you are always ultimately responsible for the correctness of your own citations. So you do want to double check everything. And the number one thing you need to double check in citations is capitalization for the article titles. A lot of times they're not going to adjust capitalization if the title was originally in all caps, and they also may not adjust it if not everything was capitalized that MLA would like for you to capitalize, which is each principal word. So make sure that you follow the MLA guidelines to double check all of your citations. You can see you can also print, email, save as PDF. And in a lot of the other databases from other companies, they now have a Google Drive icon that will allow you to save directly into your Google Drive. For right now, ProQuest is not working correctly, so I have removed it. You won't see it here. For now, just save as PDF, put it into your Google Drive yourself, and then in all the other databases, you can save directly through that Google Drive icon.